Hey there, everyone. Welcome to another fall day in Mallory's Guard. Today is October 21st, and the first frost is approaching fast. It might happen next Tuesday or Wednesday, or it might not happen until the first or second week of November, but it's coming pretty quick. Early next week, it's going to get down to 36 one night, I saw. So that's getting like powerful close. And I'd like to get my garlic in the ground, you know, so it can get established a little bit before that first frost hits. Even though it's going to be a quick dip if it does happen and it'll pick back up, I just figure it's good to get it going. And also, I took the last of my pepper plants out of that into the garden today. There's only two more pepper plants left in the ground, and that gave me the room to plant some garlic. So let's take a look. Here you can see that we have some garlic ready to plant. I have, what, 6 cloves here. Some of them are hard neck and some of them are soft neck. The hard neck ones have a harder neck coming out of them. They will also grow a scape, which will have a flower, and you cut that off before it flowers, and you can use that for a variety of cooking off things. And they're basically just garlic. I do recommend that you buy garlic that is guaranteed seed garlic, because garlic that is not seed garlic, that you would get from the store, for example, is possibly from overseas. And if it is, usually what they do is they grind off the roots from the bottom, whereas if they don't have the roots ground off, they're going to be likely to be ones from North America. And then in addition, when they grind off the root bottom, sometimes they damage the bottom of the individual cloves, and those individual cloves of course need to be able to grow their own roots as well. So with all of my garlic laid out, it's time to start preparing the bed. Here we are with a bunch of the garlics all broken apart. Here is one of the individual cloves. You can see that there's a pointy end and a flat end. Flat end goes down. That's where the roots are going to grow out of. And it's just like that, putting them in. And then I just sprinkle dirt over top of them to cover them up. Couple other plants are around there, so I'm just going to like pull those off. And that's all there is to it. That garlic is now in the ground and ready to grow. So I'm gardening using the square foot method. You can get 4 garlic plants growing in each square foot. And the either side of my beds can be used for different things. The left side is going to be used for some tomatoes, and some peppers are going to be interspersed every other foot on the right hand side. So that's why garlic is not in all of these spots. But you can see that the garlic just goes into these holes. It's not too deep that you put the garlic in. It's going to sit maybe like 1/2 inch to 1 inch below the level, the surface of the soil, and you can pack them in pretty good. So I have in here 55 garlic cloves, about 1/2 and 1/2 between soft neck and hard neck. Hard neck is more winter hardy, and we're up here in zone 6B, and so I'm not entirely sure how well the soft necks will do. But I also have a good mix of hard necks in there as well. So I'm probably going to get, given that you get at least 10 cloves from each garlic, I'm probably going to get 500 cloves. With all of the garlic in the ground, all I have to do from here on out is just brush dirt over top of each one, and we will have all the garlic ready to roll. At the very end, of course, as well, I'm going to cover all of this with mulched leaves just to give a little bit of extra insulation throughout the winter. But I would expect to see these garlic coming out of the ground in December and probably growing decently even during the snowfall that we're likely to have this year. It'll be interesting to see how well they do. Lots of times in the past I'll have garlic sticking up out through the snow in March, because it just doesn't care. It just wants to get going. So that's all there is to it. That's how you take, this was actually only 4 cloves that I planted right now. 4 cloves are going to give me at least 50 bulbs next year. I have another 2 cloves to plant. I'll be able to use some for selling. We'll use some for baking. And then on top of that, we're going to have bulbs to plant the following year, because we're going to want to keep, you know, about another 6 to 10 bulbs just for planting. But thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe and ring the bell so you can know when I release more videos. And then of course, please like the video if you found it enjoyable. And I suggest planting some of your own garlic. You could probably get a couple of cloves out of something even as small as a decent sized planter, Or just like a 4x4 piece of bed, a section of a raised bed or a garden can get lots of garlic out of that. You could actually never have to buy garlic again in your life, which would be pretty freaking cool.